Peace. Well, everybody staying in tune, living another life on that heart frequency, going with their own personal flow, you know how it go. So I just want to talk about a few things, more so manifesting your own reality and not being a victim of circumstance. So some things to better your life, I guess you could say as well. So most definitely, the first thing I would say is definitely stop playing the victim role. Get out of that victim circumstance. Yeah, things happen. Unexpected things come up in our lives. But it's important to face those things head on and always be optimistic. Live in the now. Quit focusing on the past. Quit focusing on the future. Live in the now. This is where we can heal and better our lives, in the now. Because this is the only place to manifest, in the now. So most definitely stay in the now. So as far as that go, of not being a victim, just using affirmations, using positive thinking, using things to clear your energy and not let things attach to you to pull you down and to scatter your own personal energy. Yes, this is something that starts within. You never want to scatter your energy. That all, it all starts with you as a person, as a being, as an infinite being, as we all are. We just gotta remember and realize. So, yeah, that's definitely one of the first things. You know, I'm kind of just freestyling off the top, thinking about all these things. I wanted to do it written down, but as you can see, I don't got my notes with me at this very second. So we just going, we just steady flowing. So another thing would be, you know, to pay attention to what you eat. A diet is just the way in which you eat. Turn your so-called diet into a lifestyle. 7-day vegan challenge. Raw plant-based foods. Eating things that will amplify and sustain your energy. Things that will... Eating those electric foods. Eating those alkaline foods. Because it all starts within. Getting those good sources of fuel inside your body will definitely help you to take action on your highest intentions, on your positive intentions that you wish to manifest or do throughout your life in this reality, most definitely. So, yeah, you can definitely check out a video on that. I have the video of diabetic going vegan. That's a good one to start with. Even if you're not diabetic going vegan, there's always some good little gems in there to start with. It's going vegan, as well as doing your own research on these vegan foods, these raw foods, these plant-based foods, all that type of things. Also, meditation is very important to your spiritual growth and to your balancing as a being. So definitely take at least, I would say like the bare minimum is like 20 minutes a day. 20 minutes a day, whether you start right in the morning as you get up, you meditate, or if you choose to do it at the end of the day, maybe right before you go to bed, you meditate 20 minutes. That's like the bare minimum. Me personally, I try to meditate. I do like a small meditation throughout the day. Like those would be the quick ones, like 20 minutes. That's kind of like a quick meditation. I usually do an hour meditation, or sometimes like an hour and a half, or even like almost up to like 3 hours of meditation as I go to bed. Usually that's one of my longer ones, but I definitely try to start my day out with an hour meditation, somewhere between like a 40 minutes an hour meditation, and then I do I guess smaller meditations throughout the day, even just listening to those binaural beats, even things like kind of like more ancient indigenous type of healing beats, like shamanic drums, different types of string instruments, maybe some I guess like the Chinese bamboo flute. That's always good. That's one of the ones that I like, definitely like to do, to mix that in. Whether I'm going somewhere, I kind of listen to it on my headphones, or you know, play some on like a speaker while I'm waiting to go do something, or you know, right before I go do something. Those are like the smaller meditations, but I would say definitely a meditation of 20 minutes. That's like the bare minimum in one day. Hey, if you can shoot for an hour, That's better. Shoot for 2, maybe an hour at the beginning of the day, hour at the end of the day. Hey, it's your own personal flow. However you like to do things, just kind of sharing what I've kind of experienced along my journey and how my journey's kind of been going so far. So most definitely like that. Let's see. I'm trying to think about like what else I can bring up, man. I had a train of thought, and now it's kind of drifting off. Let's see. Definitely getting into nature, most definitely. Breathing that great prana into the nose, out into the nose, down to your stomach. Hold that breath and let it back out to the nose. Or do the fire breath, the quick like type breath into the nose, out to the nose. Into the nose, out to the mouth, the fire breath. Make sure you hold that good prana, that great prana in your diaphragm, in your stomach. Hold that good air, and exhale as you need it, and inhale as you need it, as you feel. It's all your personal flow. There's many different techniques. It's all about developing your own techniques to benefit your being. So everybody's a little bit different, but we all have techniques that can benefit each other. So there's a little experience there, a little thing you can try. Let's see. Actually going back to getting in nature, definitely getting in nature. I mean, right now in these colder months, it's a little bit more difficult to get out in nature and stay in nature, as the cold is kind of, you know, get into you in different certain ways. But as long as you got the will to get out there and get in nature, then hey, it's all going to be positive. It's all going to be great to your being. It's all going to be positive benefits towards your being. Definitely. And definitely getting your grounding in nature, you know, going barefoot, getting those negative ions from Mother Earth. Because, we tend to build up positive ions throughout our body, being in all these apartment type settings and whatnot like this. But yeah, definitely get into nature, get that great air, that great prana, you know, and getting your grounding from Mother Earth, those negative ions. So yeah, that's just another thing there. Let's see. Yeah, you know, I think I'm just gonna start with that. You know, I'm sure there's a lot of things that are not popping up in my head right this very second that I would like to add, but I don't think I'm gonna do a part 2 on this. This is mainly just because in the moment I had an experience that, you know, I was hearing a lot, hearing the person's situation coming through, but I wasn't agreeing to those terms and conditions to hold that energy. I was keeping that energy away from my being, because I wanted to keep my energy clean, keep my energy intact. I'm not letting these outside things bite off me anymore. Like in my early journey, some things used to get on me and bite at me all the time. But now, you know, I got that shield up, got my black tourmaline, most definitely. That's the 12 gauge, heated heavy with that defense, you know, turning that negative energy into positive energy, most definitely. That selenite, you know, the blade of light, the sword. It's the clearing energy, clearing all that energy, just grabbing onto you, clearing your own energy and amplifying that positive energy, most definitely. Yeah, and then working with these quotes, you know, those high vibrations, keeping your vibrations high, keeping your energy high and lively, most definitely. And then now, but yeah, that's basically it. So until next time, everybody, stay peaceful, stay in harmony, stay in tune, keep living and loving life from that heart frequency. Much love.